Hi students, welcome back to my class. As you know, now we are going through lesson 5. In the previous section, we studied about diseases and types of diseases. So in this section, we are going to study about types of diseases in detail. So let's start this section with communicable diseases. So what is meant by communicable diseases? Let's see. The disease which is actually capable of being passed on briefly from one person to another is actually known as communicable disease. Or in other terms, we can say that the disease that can spread from one person to another person are called a communicable disease. So what are communicable diseases? The diseases that can spread from one person to another. So that does not mean that a person which is healthy will not have any kind of disease or will not suffer from any kind of disease. So it is not possible if the person is healthy. Okay. So the person which is healthy will be in a disease condition, and that diseased person, if it is not taking care, and if the disease passes on to another healthy person, that are called as communicable diseases. Clear? That is why it is termed as communicable diseases or communicable. Okay, so these diseases are transmitted from one person to other person. So students, you always remember that communicable diseases are communicated by or spread either by air or touch. Okay, so there are other modes of spread also. Other modes of spread of communicable diseases. So let's see. Yes, there are some common communicable diseases also. Some common communicable diseases are malaria, typhoid, cholera, common cold, tuberculosis, especially corona, then chickenpox, etc. So there are some common communicable diseases which might have heard from anywhere. So communicable diseases are not only spread through air or touch, it also spread through water, food, animals, infected equipments also. So in all, we can say that communicable diseases spread through air, water, food, animals, infected equipments and touch. So communicable diseases spread through all these modes. Each of the common communicable diseases. The first one is malaria. Actually, malaria is caused by mosquito bite, and that is why it is called as communicable disease, because mosquito and some other insects like flies and bugs, they transmit germs through their bite to the human body. So malaria is caused by mosquito bite. I hope you all clear with this. And let's see another type of communicable disease, that is measles. So measles actually spread by very tiny organisms called germs. So these are also caused by germs, and it is a type of communicable disease. How is it, or how can we say that it is a communicable disease? Yes, we can say that because when an infected person touches sneezes, so their germs are released into air and can infect a healthy person. So measles is caused by direct contact. So diseases like common cold, chickenpox, cough also spread through direct contact and air. So germs spread through direct contact and they cause diseases like common cold, chickenpox, measles and cough. So now we will see another one. Yes, that is typhoid. So typhoid is a type of communicable disease, the disease which is spread by food and water. So typhoid is spread by contaminated food and water. Some insects like flies and cockroach, they carry germs and contaminate the food and water. So diseases like typhoid, cholera, diarrhea and jaundice are caused by eating infected food or drinking polluted water. So these all are some communicable diseases, and they are spread through air, water, direct contact, infected equipments and touch. So Students, how can we cure these diseases? Is there any method to cure such diseases? Let's see. Yes, it is possible to prevent communicable diseases. So there are many ways of preventing communicable diseases. First of all, there should be proper ventilation in the house so that the house gets sanitized with the sunlight. And the second one is purified water should be used for drinking. It can also be boiled and chlorinated. So purified water, we should use purified water for drinking. Next one, hands should be washed frequently with the soap and water, and especially after passing stools. Next one, fruits and vegetables should be washed properly before consuming. Then eat cooked food and it must be covered so that flies do not sit on them. Then water should not be stagnant anywhere around the house as it can lead to breeding of mosquitoes. Then drains must be kept covered. Also, it is possible to prevent many diseases through vaccination. So students, one such method to prevent diseases is through vaccination. And most vaccines are given to children when they are young. Now let's see what is actually meant by vaccination. So vaccination is the use of special substances called vaccines to prevent specific diseases. So vaccination is the use of special substances called vaccines, and which are provided since birth time, since childhood, to prevent specific diseases. So which cannot called any harmful or any kind of disease which is affecting your life, your whole life. So vaccination is provided to the children and they are given to us childhood only. So students, I hope you all clear with this term vaccination, and I hope that you enjoyed this section and learned about diseases in detail. And the next section we will continue with a new chapter, a new topic. So keep learning, keep enjoying. Thank you.